So if you guys keep up with the videos, I'm sure most of you know I've been waiting for a reflex silver Bora to show up at the junkyard for months and months and months now. I need to replace my driver's side fender and my front bumper because they're satin silver and they're just, the colors are off. Satin silver and reflex silver like look similar, but side by side, they're completely different. So I've been waiting for a long time for a reflex silver Bora to show up. Now, Monday we had a guy come in saying, hey, I have a silver Bora. I didn't know the paint code, but I have a silver Bora, needs to get picked up. So today, the Bora is here. Now, two bad things. One, it's satin silver, so doesn't help me out. And also, all the pieces I need are all destroyed. Also, it's super windy, sorry, but hood's trashed, bumper's trashed, and both fenders are trashed. So I'm kind of glad it's a satin silver car, because this was reflex silver, I would be so sad, because I needed all of that. What's funny though, the car still runs no problem. It's a 6-speed diesel, has a cool net optic set. Actually, I got another set of this today. Actually, I got a blue set, never seen before. I got a blue set of net optics, actually out of this car over here. Another satin silver Golf that came in today. This one is the Generations Edition. So it has the blue seats, which are actually pretty cool. I think I wanna pull these and buy them and put them in the container for the States. But it had the blue and tan matched carpet. It had the blue stitch shift knob and it had the full blue net optic set, which I've never seen before. I'll show you in just a minute. But kind of a cool car. Something different. So maybe this one I want these, but kind of cool. Yeah, I was sad about this. I was so excited knowing that there was a Bora coming in and it was silver, but now it's a, I said, I'm glad it's satin silver and wrecked and not a reflex silver and wrecked. That'd be really sad. Still some nice parts though. I'll snag the taillights off this one and the hatch is, well, the trunk's super clean, but sad day. No parts for me. Voila, full net optic set. Actually in pretty good shape too, which is always awesome. And this is like the American style AC1 versus like the climatic control. So definitely a cool set. I had this in my wagon before and I swapped to the wood stuff, but pretty cool. I'll show you the side by side between this one and the blue one. The blue one looks really, really cool. All right, check this out. So over here, we have the normal black and gray net optic set, which is cool, but then bam, the full blue net optic set. Look how sick that is. Like I said, I've never seen a blue set ever, so this is pretty cool. I've seen the Generation Golf before, but never with this interior. So this is honestly super cool. I wish it was black versus tan, but still overall, very, very cool. Plus the Generation shift knob that is blue stitched, and the floor mats are up there. They're dirty, but they're still tan and blue, and it fits with the rest of the whole set, but super, super awesome. Blue set, gray set, and then obviously in my car I've got the full more the light wood set, and then I also have a dark wood set I just got. I just like collecting these pieces because, like, I don't know, this kind of stuff to me, seeing the full sets is super cool. I think, yeah, blue set is dope. Also some cool news. So this is the stock VR5 plastic crack pipe. This is my spare aluminum VR6 crack pipe. You can always see the difference here. The VR6 one is longer, but my buddy Ricky said he can weld aluminum, so we're gonna cut this one and make it the same size as this one. That way I can have an aluminum one for the VR5, because they never made one that I can find. Rather cut probably this end, bring this piece in, because we can't move the nozzle, but everything is the same. The hose outlet's there, the block off on the bottom, and then same on this one. So if everything goes smoothly, I should have a nice aluminum crack pipe for the VR5, which is awesome. You know, even though this car is got a little bit of damage, you know, a few airbags deployed, my inner core is actually down there. You can't see it, but the inner core is down there. This thing actually runs like perfect. The radio still works, AC still works. But look at this thing. No problem. 6-speed diesel. I'm not sure what engine it has in it, but like, and since the inner core is off, listen to that whistle already. Oh man, my door's a little, it's a little off. The hood's a little bit, it's fine though. Like it, like this, I think it feels like, it feels great. Like I have all the gears. Uh-oh, we got windshield wipers on, hang on. Down, there it is. This thing sounds so cool. Turn off. My tire's driving a little bit up there, it's fine though. I think this thing sounds insane. I love this thing.
Oh.
not gonna lie, this thing's actually pretty sick. 6-speed TDI Bora. I was trying to pop the hood, but it's like just straight jam shut. I might try and get the pry bar and get it open. Okay, we got her. Up you go. Put that somewhere. There it is. Look at that. I'm pretty sure this is the like the highest horsepower. This is the one you want, basically, with the red D and the red I. I think this is the one that everyone wants. It looks to be okay. The condenser doesn't look like it's been hit. Oh my God, it almost tried to kill me. Don't do that. Hang on. Stay, please. Okay, there we go. All right, so again, condenser looks good. Radiator looks good. I think it, almost all the impact was like right here on the side, which is why the intercooler is in the passenger seat. But what is this? Maybe AC, possibly. This is pushed back pretty far, but everything else looks to be like honestly okay. I said the engine runs great. It only has 160,000 kilometers, so not very many miles at all. Got the 6-speed trans on it. This ain't bad. It might be worth trying to snag the swap out of this car for something. I don't know what, but might be worth trying to save this thing. Not the car itself, but just this portion. Actually, if I can save the car. Fender, new rad support, bumper. Wouldn't be too hard to save, but I don't really care for the whole car. But I kind of want the engine out of it. For what? I don't know, but yeah, we'll see. So what I'm also curious about, excuse me, sir. Thank you. I said to get in there real quick. I'm also curious about, a lot of guys over here in Europe have told me there's also a 6-speed O2J trans that you can do with the VR5. So if I didn't want to do an O2J 5-speed, I could try and find the one out of the Sharon and do an O2J 6-speed. This car has a 6-speed as well. If you look down here, that's the same setup as an O2J. Now, I don't know if this transmission on this TDI 6-speed will work with my VR5. It'd be cool if it did, and I could just snag this trans and the 6-speed because that would be dope, but I don't know if this one will fit. So if you know if the TDI, I want to say this is an O2J as well. It has the O2J style shifter box. I'm assuming that would be the trans code on it, but I could be wrong. But if you know if the TDI 6-speed trans work for VR5, let me know. I'll do some research and see, but could be cool to run a 6-speed in the VR5 versus a 5-speed. It's kind of sad though, this car got destroyed. It was actually a pretty nice spec. TDI 6-speed had all the painted moldings, even has a sunroof, which most Mark 4s over here, to see a sunroof on one of the cars over here is actually pretty rare. So it was actually a pretty nice spec of car. Had the like boring kind of seats, but overall not bad. And then a little bit, just minor. Okay, that'll buff out. Give you guys a quick look at the transmission. Like I said, it looks like it's an O2J. I can't see where it's stamped. Usually it's on the bottom side, and I can't see it right now, but it looks like it's an O2J 6-speed. That'd be sick if it was. And if we look over here, we can see the engine code is AJM, and I'm pretty sure that's the one that everyone wants. You usually can tell by the lettering here when it has the two red. I'm pretty sure that's the highest horsepower one, like the one everyone wants. So I'll have to look it up and see, but I think this is the one. I also want to say, I think there's a possibility we can take the turbo setup off of this engine and put it on Casey's AXR and make some more power. So sadly, no bumper, no fender for my car. It'll have to stay unmatching for a little while longer, but I was able to snag some cool pieces. We have the satin silver smooth molding Golf Girl front bumper, some Bora taillights, the Bora trunk lid over there, and then a set of mirrors, the one stubby and one normal size, and then some Euro rebars down there, all of which will all go in our container being shipped to the States later on. Now, if you're not quite sure what I'm talking about, I've been collecting parts like this for quite a long time now, just stocking up with the hopes of getting a container, shipping all the parts back to the States and obviously off to you guys. I got in touch with a buddy of mine. We had everything all squared away, got the cost, all that kind of stuff. So now it's just my job to collect and collect and collect. And I have a lot of parts now, but to fill a container top to bottom, front to back, and like use every inch of the container, yeah, I'm gonna need a lot more parts. I have a lot now, but I'm gonna need a whole bunch more. So hopefully, like I said, maybe another month or so of collecting parts, fill a container off of the States, and you guys can enjoy tons of Euro parts. But overall, definitely a good day for parts. And right over there, speaking of parts, the little Mark III Cabrio back over there, the one I've been eyeing for a very long time, I finally got the green light. So next week, we are fully gutting that car, taking everything out of it. So yeah, next week, RIP little Cabrio. She's done. Okay, so I have good news and I have bad news. The good news is I got home, I got a DHL tracking update. It's saying my VR5 parts should be here this Saturday, which is dope. The bad news is
I won't be here this Saturday. I don't know where I'll be, but I won't be here. Casey planned us a trip, didn't tell me where we're going. So this Saturday, I'm gonna be gone somewhere. Don't know where, but my parts will be here. So I'll probably ask Jordan or somebody come by, grab the parts, put them in the house. But it's sick, the VR5 parts will be here this Saturday, which means next week we can start the rebuild.
I'll tell you guys what though. I cannot wait to start putting this thing back together. Again, I appreciate all you guys' patience. I know it took a little while, but the ball is moving. We're making progress. The parts will be here this weekend. We'll have a nice custom aluminum crack pipe. Hopefully that Junkyard 6-speed trans works out. Then we'll have a transmission. We are just moving right along. I said, it's not gonna happen like in the next couple of weeks, but very, very soon, we're gonna have amazing sounds. This little Savoy is gonna be ripping around and I cannot wait. I put the video clip in the last video, I think it was, of the exhaust, how this car sounded before. I forgot how amazing the VR5 sounded. All that was a muffler delete. Stock cat, stock like midsection pipe, and then just a muffler delete. And it sounded ridiculous. It popped like crazy. Such an awesome sound. So I can't wait to have a nice full exhaust in this thing. Oh, making progress feels good. The wife just rolled up in the wagon. This thing be looking so dirty. These wheels are actually gloss black, not matte black. It'll be cool though if that turbo setup from the AJM motor will work on this one, and then we can have some more power.
So I decided to take some time and go through and clean all my Mark IV interior sets, and look how sick this looks. So start from the left and go all the way to the right.
This is all my net optics pieces. I have one full set, so this is a black base driver's side controller. And then you have cup holder, AC, all that kind of stuff all the way down. And I have a few spare handle pieces, a few side pieces here. And then I have a tan base, you can see down there. So black base, tan base. And then this one is a right-hand drive controller with a black base. So I have a bunch of net optic stuff you can see. And then, they are my favorite, honestly. This blue set is just so cool. And it cleaned up really, really nice. There's almost like no nicks or any issues like at all. This set looks so cool. I don't know how rare it is, but this is the first set I've ever seen in the blue. So I think it must be decently rare, and it has a shift knob. It's just a cool, it just looks cool. And then this is my partial dark wood set I have over here. Really nice color to it. I'm missing just the door handles and a shift knob for this set, but overall, pretty cool. And then I have this one random like aluminum one here. I'm pretty sure this was a net optic one. They just sanded down. But overall, lots and lots. You can see how easy it is to find the net optic stuff, which is pretty softer still. It looks really cool, but it's pretty easy to find. The blue though, like I said, if you've seen blue before or have a blue set, let me know, because this is the first that I've seen and I love it. It's so sick. But yeah, there's all of my Mark IV interior pieces. And I also have a spare this one, but it's like a stick-on wood piece. It's not like the, I don't know, it's kind of meh, but I have that one too. So as you guys can see, I really, really, really like collecting parts. I just love seeing all the cool variations. It's just super awesome to me. And you guys know, I want to build a shop one day, have like lift, paint booth, everything in my shop, but I also want to have a spot in the shop that's just for parts. I want to collect everything. I want to collect all the taillights, Mark 1, 2, 3, 4. I want to have like this, all the colors, smoked red, blue, green. I want to have like every variation of everything, just because, like, I don't know, it's just so cool. I enjoy pulling parts, and like, I might be a hoarder a little bit, but you know what, it is what it is. It brings me happiness, and I just like having, I like walking down here and just seeing all of these parts. Granted, a lot of them will go in the container, but still, right now it's cool just having like this so much stuff.
I actually never showed this. This is a Golf 3 front blend, that little like pig nose looking piece right there. I got this from Nick when he was down. Cool little piece, like new old stock basically, not painted, original box. Definitely a cool piece. Might use it for the Savoy, might sell it, don't know yet. Also got these. These are kind of cool. High-end tuning powered by Bonrath. These are actually, look at this. These are strut tower caps made by Bonrath. You can see right there it says by Bonrath. Kind of hard to make out, but it says right there. Cool little pieces. Do they do anything like performance-wise? I don't think so. Maybe a little bit, but it's more of like a show kind of thing, but definitely a cool piece.
You know, a minute ago I said I wanted to have like a room in my shop for parts, but thinking about it now, I'm probably gonna need a whole separate warehouse just for my parts. I'll have the cars in one, and the other one, like I want shelves to the ceiling where I can just have wheels and just everything physically possible.
And then over here, I haven't showed these yet either. This is a blue Bora 2.0 trunk I picked up, along with the silver one I got today. And then over here, I have two Euro Golf hatches, the wagon ones. Bam and bam, super nice condition. Very, very cool. So you have a Mark IV wagon in the States and you want a Euro hatch, I'll have some coming in the container. So yeah, that is your update for the parts room. By the time the container gets here, it's probably gonna be floor to ceiling with parts literally everywhere. I'm so excited for that to happen. Yo, the stand here and just look. It's just so awesome. All right, so right now we are on our way to go meet Ricky. I'm gonna drop off the coolant pipes, that way he can modify the one, shorten it, and then we'll have a nice fancy aluminum coolant pipe for the VR5. All right, so I'm currently at the airport on base, parked between a lovely Mark II and a very nice Mark VII. I'm not sure if Ricky parked in this parking lot or if he parked over in the parking garage over there. He's at a super nice Toyota Corolla 886. This thing's sick. So I'm not sure if he parked here or over there, but I'll just wait until he texts me and we'll see. Oh, there's my dude. What's going on, man? All right, so I haven't filmed anything in probably, what, hour and a half we've been out here? We've been out here for like a minute, but Ricky and I like just talked for a long time. He's a super cool dude, but I gave him maybe steel, right, you think? Or maybe?
I think this is actually steel. Look at the way it feels and probably the weight.
Yeah, it's actually pretty thick. I thought it was aluminum, but it's some sort of metal. But my man, he's gonna try and, we're gonna shorten this side, right?
Yeah, we're gonna shorten that spout. Because you look at it right here, if you line everything up,
yeah, it's all direct.
Course, it's going to be, maybe an inch and a half bigger on this side. Probably, so yeah. Maybe take an inch and a half out of this portion. You'll be able to shorten it down, yep. Keep this right level, and I think you'll be straight.
Like I said, whatever you want to try, if it works, awesome. I wasn't going to use it at all. So the fact that we have a chance to make it work, that'd be super cool.
Yeah.
Like I said, I think this might be the very first one. Like, correct me if I'm wrong. I haven't seen, I looked online. It's even hard to find the OEM replacement for the VR5 because they didn't make too much like aftermarket stuff. So if this works, that would be sick. I'm excited for it.
Same here, man. I think it'll be good. Probably give me 1 to 2 days, I'll be straight.
That's quick.
Yeah.
I'm in absolutely no rush. So anyway, wherever you take your time, do your thing. But yeah, that'd be awesome. I can't wait to see it. I'm excited.
Too easy, man. Too easy.
Sick. All right, boys and girls, our coolant pipe is in good hands. I'm super excited to see when it's done. Like I said, this might be the very first like aluminum or steel metal crack pipe for VR5, which would be pretty cool. So I'm excited. Huge shout out to Ricky. Big thank you to him. He also has a YouTube channel. He doesn't film many videos, he said, but I think I talked him into making some more. Like I said, he has a really cool Toyota Corolla 886. This car is sweet. I actually put a video on my Instagram story like 2 days ago, but the car is cool. So I think he's going to Hockenheim Ring this Saturday to do some drifting and some more stuff. But hopefully, we'll see him making some more videos soon, and then I'll make some videos with him at some point, showing off the car and just hanging out. He's a super cool dude. He's very similar to me. We literally sat here and talked for like 2 hours, and it's cold and like raining outside, but when you find good people, it's fun to really talk to them and get to know them. So that was definitely cool. Now I'm gonna head home. We have to pack and leave in the morning for I don't know where.
All right, it is currently 10:30, just got home.
Gonna have the video here. I honestly didn't even plan on making a video today, but then the Bora came in and then I hit up Ricky about the crack pipe and then I worked out. So very, very cool stuff. Decided to put something together. Hope you guys still enjoyed. Like I said, I have no idea where we're going tomorrow. Probably more of a travel vlog, but of course I always try to find some cars for you guys if I can. But either way, I want to share the experience with you guys. So hopefully you guys still enjoyed. Do not forget, be thankful for every single day. We'll see you guys next time. Peace.
Doing just fine before I met you.